Hello students, in this video we will solve the related questions of isosceles triangle. So here is our first question of exercise 7.3. So in this question it is said that these two are isosceles triangle. So we have given that AB is equals to AC and DB is equals to DC. Okay, what we have to prove is triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. So for that, first of all, we have to take in triangle ABD and triangle ACD. Look, ABD, this is the triangle, and ADC, this is the triangle. So in these two triangle, AD is equals to AD. This is common side. Here also it is AD. Here also it is AD. This is common. Okay, also it is given that AB is equals to AC because ABC is isosceles triangle, and also DB is equals to DC because BDC is isosceles triangle. Okay, so now from here we have triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. Okay, by side congruency rule. Okay, so now we can say that these two triangles are congruent to each other. Okay, so here we can take angle DAB is equals to angle DAC by CPCD. Okay, so now we can say that line AD is bisecting angle A. Okay, from here we can say that AD is bisecting angle A because we have AD is common side and angle B, this part is equals to this part. Okay, so this angle is equals to this angle. Now we have to prove for second triangle. So we take in triangle ABP and triangle ACP, ABP and triangle ACP. So we know that AB is equals to AC because ABC is an isosceles triangle. Okay, now these two sides are equal and this is the angle. So we can say that now this, we have angle DAB is equals to angle DAC, or we can say that PAC, PAB is equals to PAC because AP is a straight line. Okay, so here this is already proved by CPCD. Now this is the side, this is the angle, and AP is common. AP is equals to AP. So triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP by side angle side congruency rule. Okay, so now if AP is a straight line, we can also say that AP is bisecting angle A as well. Okay, now what we have to show that AP bisect angle A as well as angle D. Now we have to show that these two angles equal. So we can say that this line is bisecting this one. So for that we have to take the triangle BDC. Okay, we have to take this triangle. So now we know that these two triangles, triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP. So from here we can take BP is equals to CP as common. Okay, now we can take here, look, we can take BP is equals to CP, okay, by CPCT. Okay, now in triangle BDP and CDP, in this, these two triangles, we know that BD is equals to CD, okay, because it is an isosceles triangle. PD is equals to PD, common side. and BP is equals to CP. This is by CPCT. So by side angle, by side theorem, these two triangles are CDP, congruent to each other by side. So we can say that angle PDB is equals to angle PDC. Okay, now PD bisects angle A. Okay, so by this statement, AD is bisecting angle A and PD is bisecting angle D. Okay, by these two statements, we can say that AP bisects angle A as well as angle D. Okay, now fourth thing what we have to prove is that this part, look, if these two triangles are congruent to each other, by CPCT we can say that angle DPB is equals to angle DPC by CPCT. Okay, look, we have already proved that BP, this is equals to BP is equals to CP, this part. Okay, so we know that AP is a bisector, but we have to show it that it is perpendicular bisector, means angle P is equals to 90 degree. So we know that also angle DPB plus angle DPC is equals to 180 degree. Reason, BC is a straight line. Okay, then these two are adjacent angles. Now DPB is equals to DPC. So we can write angle DPB plus angle DPC can also be written as angle DPB. This is equals to 180 degree. Then 2 angle DPB is equals to 180 degree and angle DPB is equals to 90 degree. Okay, and also we have BP is equals to CP. Then we can say that AP is perpendicular bisector of BC. Okay, now let's move to question number 2. In this question, it is said that AD is an altitude of an isosceles triangle ABC. So let me draw a triangle ABC in which AB is equals to AC because it is an isosceles triangle. Okay, now AD is an altitude, so it is given that the angle between them is 90 degree. Okay, so now we have to show that AD bisect BC. We have to show that AD this bisect BC. So let us take the point D. Now we have to prove BD is equals to DC. Okay, so in triangle ADB and triangle ADC, now in these two triangles we know that angle ADB is equals to angle ADC is equals to 90 degree. Okay, this is our right angle. Now in front of right angle, AB and AC lies, these are hypotenuse. So for ADB, the side AB is hypotenuse, and for triangle ADC, AC is hypotenuse. Okay, so these are, because ABC is an isosceles triangle, it is given this is hypotenuse. And look, this angle, this is the hypotenuse and AD is the common side. AD is equals to AD, this is common. So this is one of the side. Then by RHS we can say that triangle ADB is congruent to triangle ADC by RHS congruency rule. Okay, so we can say that now we can take BD is equals to DC by CPCT. Now this shows that AD bisects, hence AD bisect BC. Okay, now we have to prove AD bisect angle A. Also from these two triangles, if these two triangles are congruent, we can say that angle BAD is equals to angle CAD. Okay, these two triangles are equal, then we can say that hence AD bisect angle A. Okay, what we have done, this is 90 degree. Okay, this side are common to this side. This side is common to this side. AB is equals to AC and AD is common. So by right angle hypotenuse side congruency rule, triangle ADB, this triangle is congruent to this triangle. Okay, and if these two triangles are congruent, we can take their corresponding side as equal. So BD is equals to DC. This shows that AD bisect BC and also AD bisect angle A. So BAD is equals to CAD. So we can say that these two angles are equal to each other, then AD is bisecting angle A as well. Okay, now in question number third, it is given that AB is AB, BC and AM, altitude AM is equals to the PQ, QR and altitude PN of another triangle respectively. So here we have given these parts. Now we have to prove for ABM, ABM, this triangle and this triangle. So AB is equals to PQ and AM is equals to PN. Look, these are medians. It is given in question that AM and PN are medians. So we can, if BC is equals to QR, then their half will also be equal. Half of BC is equals to half of QR. Okay, so half of BC is BM and half of QR is QN. Okay, so now triangle ABM and triangle PQN. In these two triangles, we have AB, this side is equals to PQ, given, and AM is equals to PN, it is also given, and we have found that BM is equals to QN. So triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN by side congruency rule. Now these two triangles are congruent, this ABM and PQN, so we can take angle B is equals to angle Q by CPCT. Okay, angle B is equals to angle Q by CPCT. Okay, now we have to prove for triangle ABC and triangle PQR. So in these two triangles, it is given that AB is equals to PQ. Okay, also it is given that BC is equals to QR in question. Now angle B is equals to angle P, angle Q. Okay, by CPCT, already proved. So this is the side, this is the angle, this is the side. So two sides and their included angle of one triangle is equal to the two sides and the included angle of another triangle. This is our theorem SAS. So we can say that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR by SAS theorem. Okay, now in question number fourth, it is said that BE and CF are two equal altitudes of triangle ABC. Okay, if A, B and C, then BE, then from B point there is a altitude. So this is E and CF. So from C point, this is F. Look, we have to use RHS congruency rule only. So look, this is the 90 degree angle. Okay, then for triangle AEB, or either AB is hypotenuse because angle E is 90 degree, or BC is hypotenuse. And similar way, if we look at triangle BFC, this part is 90 degree. So either side AC will be 90 degree because this is AC will be hypotenuse, or BC. So in both these altitudes, we have BC as common altitude. So we can take in triangle BEC, and this is BEC, then CFB, and triangle CFB. Now we have BE is equals to CF because these are equal altitudes. Okay, and angle BEC is equals to angle BEC is equals to angle CFB is equals to 90 degree, because these are altitudes, so angle between them is 90 degree, and BC is equals to BC. This is common hypotenuse. So we can say that triangle BEC is congruent to triangle CFB by RHS. Okay, now if these two triangles are common to each other, then look, for triangle CFB angle B is common, and for triangle BEC angle C is common. So we can say that angle B is equals to angle C by CPCT. Okay, now side opposite to angle B is side AC, and side opposite to angle C is side AB. Okay, so here statement we will write, side opposite to equal angles are equal. Okay, so now AC is equals to AB, hence we can say that triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Okay, now let's move to last question of this exercise. So in this, ABC is an isosceles triangle. It is already given that ABC is an isosceles triangle. So this is A, this is B, this is C. Draw AP perpendicular to BC. Look, it is said that this is perpendicular to BC. This is side P. So this is 90 degree. This is also 90 degree. Now we have to show that angle B is equals to angle C. Look, in this we have to use RHS. Okay. Now also we can prove it by AB is equals to AC. So angle opposite to equal sides are also equal. So angle opposite to AB is angle C, and angle opposite to AC is angle B. So B is equals to angle C, but we have to use it RHS congruency rule here. It is said in the question. So we will take in triangle APB and triangle CPB, CAP. Okay, so we have, look, here also AP, here also AP. So we have a side. Look, first of all, take right angle. So angle BPA is equals to triangle CPA is equals to 90 degree, because AP is an altitude. Okay, this is our right angle. Now in front of it, AB, for this triangle AB is hypotenuse, and for triangle CPA AC is hypotenuse. Okay, so because triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle, this is hypotenuse. Now AP is the common side for both of them, common side. So by right angle hypotenuse side congruency criterion, triangle APB is congruent to triangle CAP. Okay, these two triangles are congruent to each other by RHS. So we can say that BP is equals to PC. And also angle B is equals to angle C by CPCT. Because this is what we have to prove. So there, for triangle ABP, angle B is common, and for triangle APC, this is the common angle, so angle B is equals to angle C. Now in our next video will be our last video for this chapter, and in that we will discuss inequalities, about inequalities of triangles.